Normally, I work in layers, building up paintings slowly. It's an attenuated process, but it does really make sure that I get the forms right. Usually, I work from drawings or photographs, or well, usually a mixture of both, and painted sketches. But one of the things I enjoy most, and one of the things I learn from a lot, is working directly from life in painted sketches. And that's what we're going to do today. This is the sort of thing that I usually end up with in one working session. Usually working sessions last about two or three hours. That's about as much as I can hold together these days. I also work from life, and it's something which, to be honest, it's something I really enjoy. There's a sense of journey, and there's an excitement because you're not, expectations aren't the same as they are with a painting which is you're going to put before the public and up for sale. There are things you don't have to worry about in terms of accuracy of colour and so on. You can just try things out, which is what we're going to do. This old fellow's been around in my studio for ages. Usually, he has young, beautiful young models swooning up against him. And this is one of the most difficult bits. It's much easier once you start blocking the actual tones in, because you can see masses better than you can see outlines. I suppose this guy's supposed to be the epitome of manliness. And He's got the right attitude. Slightly angry. There's always a point, which I haven't reached yet, where you think, actually, that's it. We're getting somewhere. And I haven't got there yet. Slightly torturous, this bit, because if you don't get the face right, nothing's right. It's, approximately right. Amazing how we're evolved to look at faces and have an emotional response to them, like, yes, you're part of the tribe, etc. It's always good to stop and look from a distance. The other thing, I've found a source of lead white.
Right, so explains lead white to me, why it's...
Well, it has very particular qualities to do with its opacity, which is low, and its...
Low opacity.
It has low opacity, yes. Well, lower than titanium white. What you've got to remember is that for centuries, nobody had anything else. So all the great masters, all the great paintings that we, you know, that are founded, have created our Western tradition, have been made with lead white. One of the things you have to do is, if you want something to be solid, to be opaque, you've got to pile the paint on. You know, it can't be thin. It's got to really be meaty. So this is where people like Titian, Rembrandt, Velasquez, you know, they started really using that amount, not to deny the fact that you were putting lots on, which earlier painters did, but to actually make something out of it, you know, to make it an expressive part of the painting. And in doing so, they brought an element of the painter into the painting. This was the formation of Romanticism, of course, where what the painter is seeing, what the painter is feeling, is part of the painting. It also ties in with individualism as an idea in the way people think about the world. It's only been, what is it, 3 hours? But it seems like 5 minutes, actually. As I said before, I do enjoy doing this, but it is a bit exhausting. And in a way, the sort of routines that I establish with the way I paint other, the things that I do, which are more public, is restful. This is exciting, it's enervating, and it's, you learn a lot, but I can't do it too often.